Avinash, thanks so much for taking the time out and joining us. Good morning. What's your sense, Avinash? We've had a massive rally from Reliance already. Do you reckon it can participate more and help the markets, or will it take a breather and therefore the markets too should watch out for that?
Good morning, Niraj. Niraj, my sense is after a 15% pop-up on the stock in the last 1 week, I think one will possibly see some sort of consolidation now in Reliance. Nevertheless, actual numbers have to improve because, currently market is expecting that this Facebook deal could mean that, debt on the balance sheet could reduce, significantly. Our sense is that numbers could possibly improve only going forward. But in the near term, I think with a 15% pop-up, I think it's better to, not buy anything fresh at these levels. Our sense is that we could see a little bit of consolidation and a kind of a moderate sell-off. You could possibly see, participants from the private sector banks, life insurance companies, hopefully if these numbers are better than street estimates, you could see a big spike from these counters. And I think the markets could be very well looking at IndusInd Bank numbers, which are keenly awaited today. What kind of management commentary comes out on the loan book growth, on the asset quality. So I think, one could get a pleasant surprise if possibly numbers are better than what the street expects.
Okay, just before we get to numbers, and I think we'll do that in just moments from now, Avinash, but I have to ask you about this pain that all these NBFCs are seeing. Do you think the drubbing has been too severe? I mean, a Bajaj Finance in Friday session went down to 1975 or thereabouts. Do you think the pain of the near term is in the price, or it'll depend on when the lockdown opens up?
Well, I think, Niraj, clearly, when the lockdown opens is going to be a crucial factor. Current news reports state that the current lockdown could be further extended by another fortnight. And I think the markets are clearly looking at the fact that until the lockdown is not lifted, it could be impacting Bajaj Finance quite significantly. In fact, the management had gone on record saying that extension of the lockdown would possibly mean a lot of loss of business for them. And over and above, asset quality issues would obviously stand out. So I think we could see a little bit of softness further. But I think overall, we would like to await, the Q4 numbers and the management commentary to, take a fresh call.
Okay. So, well, let's wait and watch what happens here to some of these stocks as well. And I think, one, the management con call of Bajaj Finance told us a few things. The pit is... let's see if the lockdown gets extended in states, in cities like Mumbai and Pune, for example, or some of the other pockets as well. Some confirmations or some ideas of that will come in post the Prime Minister and the Chief Minister call. I think it would be very, very crucial. A lot of states have already sent the murmurs or desires of wanting to extend the lockdown by another couple of weeks. As important as it might be from a health perspective, since we're talking about markets here, it would be disastrous of sorts because businesses stay locked down for another 15 days and then the momentum just accelerates on the downside. So this wouldn't be pretty, but it would be what it would be. So let's wait and watch what happens there and then we will talk more. Avinash, the other bit is results. And I think before we talk about Mindtree results, just a quick update since you mentioned life insurance companies. What did you make of ICICI Prudential? Because on Friday, we had this downtick because of the monthly numbers released and they looked very wobbly. ICICI Prudential results for the quarter gone by have been okay, but they have expressed confidence about maintaining their earlier guidance. So therefore, would you be a buyer in ICICI Prudential from a short term or from a long term perspective?
No, I think Niraj, ICICI Pru reported numbers which were in line with expectations, and I think the management clearly stating that they would be maintaining the guidance gives a great amount of comfort as far as the long-term prospects of this business is concerned. Our sense is that whatever growth recovery is expected is going to happen post-September. So I think this could be a good opportunity for investors to chip in for a longer term kind of positioning in this sector. I would not be surprised that this sector could bounce back equally sharply once normalcy happens. And I think you could see definitely premiums as well as the growth momentum coming back again after the second half, after the first half of FY21. So I think maybe the first half could be a little softer on numbers. Obviously, you know, with the lockdown, you know, being extended, if it happens, then I think it's going to slow down the momentum, at least in the first half. So I would not be worried in the longer term. But yes, in the short term, the stock could remain a little bit of with a negative kind of bias.
So you would believe that the bias could be negative despite the fact that they have done reasonably okay in the quarter, right?
Yeah, I think in the short term, Niraj, this fact would remain. But longer term, I would believe that, you know, this is a stock where one could obviously start nimbling and, you know, accumulate this stock for the longer term. Because business model and the longer term prospects of the insurance sector continue to be bright. This is just a hiccup for the next, say, one or two quarters.
Okay. The other big or reasonably big development that happened, Avinash, was Apollo Tyres, right? Warburg Pincus converting those convertible preference shares into equity. Now, their stake goes up to nearly 40%, pseudo promoter, right, so to say. Is this a meaningful shift or event in the lifeline of Apollo? And does it give the minority investor any clue about what to do with this stock if they have it in the portfolio or if they maybe even want to buy it?
Well, I think, Niraj, as far as tire stocks are concerned, our sense is that despite the fact that, you know, crude prices have corrected sharply, and that is definitely a big positive for most of the tire companies since, you know, a large part of their raw material is related to crude. The overall headwinds in the automobile market are not positive at all. And I would not be surprised that at least for the next one or two quarters, you know, recovery looks to be a bit tough because Apollo Tyres is a very large player to OEM players in the commercial vehicle, in the passenger car space. They have a large replacement market share also. So I think unless and until we see some positive, you know, sentiments in the automotive market, which, you know, unlikely going to happen in the near term, I would believe it would be a market performer. But yes, probably FY22 could be a lot better, but FY21 is going to be a lot challenging. So I would not be in a hurry to buy the stock. I would prefer to, you know, wait for further news flows, you know, from the large automobile players. And only once positive recovery happens, then I think you could see all these tire companies actually getting re-rated again.
Avinash, if you had Mindtree, if somebody has Mindtree in the portfolio, what should he or she do?
So I think, Niraj, looking at the numbers and the kind of outperformance, both in terms of top line as well as profitability, and listening to the management con call, I think one thing is very clear that, you know, downside for this stock is well protected. I would believe that, you know, obviously, fresh buying would not be advised. But definitely, you know, if at all the COVID-19, you know, extended lockdown continues, then it could have some dampening effect on their travel and hospitality kind of verticals. But overall, I would believe that this could be at best a market performer. Markets are not going to, you know, re-rate this stock, at least in the near term. But yes, hopefully post-September, you know, one could definitely see better improvement in the margins and the outlook. So I would believe it's a hold. I would not be buying fresh at these levels.
Now, viewers, keep in mind one more update that pharma companies have a bit of a fundamental small cloud to themselves. So technically, Ipca Labs may look like a buy and it could well turn out to be that. But Avinash Gurakshekar, I want you to come in and tell us if you believe there could be an impact fundamentally on the likes of Cadila and Ipca because of the USFD advisory issued on Friday against hydrochloroquine.
I think, Niraj, this is going to be definitely be a sentimentally a negative news flow, at least in the near term, considering the fact that, you know, Ipca and Cadila are key players in this, you know, pharmaceutical product. Our sense is that fundamentally, you know, Ipca continues to show very strong numbers. And I think the fourth quarter numbers are going to be extremely solid. How the business pans out for the next year is going to be entirely dependent on how, you know, consuming markets, you know, develop. But overall, I would believe that more than Cadila, I am extremely positive on, you know, Ipca Laboratories, considering the fact that they have a good blend of domestic and US markets for almost 200 to 300 branded formulations. So I would believe that, you know, if at all the stock prices do correct, Niraj, for Ipca, I think it would be a good opportunity to accumulate the stock. Yes, there could be a little bit of softening considering this negative news flow which has happened, you know, in the previous week. But this could be a good opportunity to accumulate Ipca.
Okay. What about you, Avinash Gurakshekar? Any view on IndusInd? I mean, can the bank surprise? And if it gives out a positive surprise, do you think there will be buying here?
I think Niraj, you know, the propensity to get a positive surprise this time looks pretty remote, considering the fact that, you know, the CV business and the MFI business are going to be definitely pain points in the near term. The management had already hinted about asset quality issues in the third quarter conference call. And I think more than the profitability of this quarter, I think what could be the outlook of the management going forward, and typically in terms of the asset quality, in terms of the loan book growth, and especially on the CV business and the MFI business would be, you know, key factors to watch. So I would not be too keen to buy, you know, the stock ahead of the results. Would better wait for the management commentary and some more clarity once the con call happens today.
Avinash, now that you might have got the weekend also to analyze the news flow better, is Reliance Industries worth a portfolio addition at these valuations?
I think, Niraj, as I mentioned earlier, we believe that Reliance definitely is a good long-term portfolio addition. I would personally believe that, you know, I would wait for a minor correction to enter in. The bigger plus for Reliance is that, you know, the Jio business is going to be a key driver for their revenue and profitability going forward. And I think hopefully, you know, once the debt on the balance sheet gets, you know, reduced, hopefully in the next 3 to 6 months, you could possibly see a good amount of re-rating further. But at these levels, we have been telling our clients to hold on. We have been buyers in the stock at lower levels, and our sense is, you know, the stock would consolidate. After a 15% pop-up last week, for a large cap stock like Reliance, I think it makes sense to wait for some time and probably enter into the stock at some minor correction. And then, you know, obviously we expect a decent risk reward over the next 12 to 18 months.
Okay, some mid-caps at the end of the pre-open session, which seem to be doing well. If you just quickly mark them, Sanghi shows a start of some 17%, Saregama India about 11%, Jamna Auto about 8.5%. There is HOEC, which is up about 8%. So do watch out for some of those small cap names as well. They could be interesting movers. Vimta Labs is up about 7.5 to 8% and Symphony is showing some gains for itself as well. So good start to all of those names. Vinati the Organics 2.5. RT Industries hasn't budged too much, so that might be an interesting one. Avinash, I think did we speak about RT? If we have, then leave it. But otherwise, if we haven't, did you have a chance to look at the business update?
Yeah, I think, Niraj, our sense is that RT Industries is one of the largest specialty chemical players. And I think, you know, considering the fact that, you know, their global customers are definitely facing challenging headwinds, possibly for the next 1 or 2 quarters, Niraj, one could see a little bit of hiccup. But we are positive on the company over the longer term. In fact, on the entire specialty chemical space, we believe that post-September, I think things should be back to normal. And I think, you know, this time, these companies could perform much better than the previous year, considering the fact that supply shortages are definitely going to make prices move up further, and I think margins could definitely get better. So we believe we are positive on the stock, but yes, in the near term, the stock could be volatile.
Okay, Avinash, just a follow-up. Steel companies, and from the POSCO results, there was some negative read-through, right? I mean, the management expects challenges. They have trimmed the calendar year revenue and shipments guidance as well. Nomura sees the next quarter to be weighed down by lower steel prices and volumes, and what impacts POSCO might well impact the steel makers as well. What do you do with a Tata Steel, JSW, JSPL?
I think, Niraj, I would avoid this sector for the time being, considering the fact that, you know, this is a fairly highly leveraged sector, and I think demand has contracted significantly post the lockdown. Production is also down, and I think as far as Tata Steel is concerned, our sense is that they have a large exposure in Europe. And unless and until some package is given to them, it's going to be a difficult situation for them to manage the debt on the balance sheet. So I would not be surprised that possibly Tata Steel could record a huge loss in the coming fourth quarter. And I think the outlook and commentary for the coming year is going to be extremely important, which at this point of time looks a little uncertain.
One quick additional perspective from you, Avinash Gorakhshekar. Because ICICI Prudential is starting off so strong, would you be tempted to buy into HDFC Life or SBI Life?
No, I think our preference would be SBI Life and then HDFC Life, Niraj. We have been quite positive on SBI Life, and our sense is that, leaving alone maybe the fourth quarter numbers and the first half of September, I would believe that, you know, recovery in this sector looks quite well poised beyond September. So I think these are stocks which should be, you know, accumulated on every decline. But yes, SBI Life around 700 odd rupees definitely could qualify as a good risk reward bet. for investors who want to take a long shot in this sector.
Well, thank you.